Hey, Deficit Crew, this is 51DSS. Watching your gun cleaning video. We're cleaning my future XD40. And while watching you clean that gun, I kept thinking, and the same thing when you were cleaning the Dan Wesson revolver in your earlier video. I kept thinking that what you really need is one of these. This is a Tipton 26-piece Ultra Jag and Best Bore Brush set. The thing about these is that, first of all, they're pretty inexpensive. I think you can pick up this little kit at Midway USA or maybe at your local Cabela's or Bass Pro Shop or Gun Shop. You can find these there. I don't know. I think I paid $20, $25 for the thing. But anyway, your bore brushes are up here, and your jags are all down here. And the beauty of these little things is that each of these bore brushes is caliber specific. So it says right up here, there's little text right in here under each hole, each slot, that tells you the caliber that the bore brush is made for. So you got 30 caliber bore brush for. For example, I believe that's for the 410 bore or 40. But anyway, and the same with the Jags, they're caliber specific. And the reason you really need to use one of these is to ensure that when you're cleaning your gun, you're not scraping the inside of your bore with the little shaft or the metallic part right here, this harder material here. It's probably not good to scrape the bore with that. And that's kind of what happens when you say, for example, you take a 22 caliber brush and you stick it into the bore of a, say, a 45 caliber pistol or in this case the 40 Smith and Wesson, and you kind of stick it in there and you and here, let me I'll just use this for demonstration. Just first of all, let's demonstrate this as clear. So I'm not going to disassemble the gun, but I'll just kind of show you what I'm talking about here. You take the smaller brush, say like for the 22 caliber or smaller, a little 17 HMR brush, and you stick it in the end of the bore of a 45 caliber, and you're kind of pushing it against the sides there, trying to brush it. Well, what you're doing actually is you're scraping the inside of your bore with the end of the shaft on the brush, and that's not what you want to do. What you want to do is you want to find the correct bore brush. Let me see if I can find the 45 ACP here. Where are we? There it is, right there. All right, this is the bore brush made for the 45 ACP. There's the barrel. It goes in, and you see that the brushes actually engage the material or the inside diameter of the barrel itself. And the shaft of the brush isn't making contact with the barrel. And you want to avoid doing that if you can, because over time that can harm or damage your barrel. So anyway, you can pick up one of these Tipton Ultra Jag kits or some similar type. It doesn't have to be a Tipton, but you can find these kits. They're pretty inexpensive, readily available, real easy to use. The thread pattern on the end fits that little rod that you're using right there will work just fine. And I recommend getting this. It's just a good thing to do. That makes cleaning a lot easier. You can just go right to the correct part and, or the correct jag or the correct brush and get your gun cleaned up efficiently and properly that way. Also, I just wanted to point out that you should probably, it's preferable to use a jag rather than that little slotted piece that you're using that you're threading the end of the patches through and kind of angling it in, because that little piece with the eye on it is actually going to scrape the inside of your barrel. Whereas with a jag, right here, just like this, it's got a real sharp little point on it. Hopefully it'll focus on here for you. I don't know if that'll help get it against the background of my shirt there. But anyway, what you do is you take your patch, you dip it, you take your patch and you dip it in the hoppies or some whatever solvent, your CLP, whatever solvent you're going to use, and you put it over the sharp point of your jag and pull it down on there. It goes on pretty good. Let's see if I can get it on there. There we go. And then this actually goes into the bore of the gun like this. As it goes in, you'll see that the patch actually folds back against the shaft of the jag so that you're actually only contacting the inside of your barrel with the patch and not with the metal. So the jag is the best way to go. It ensures that you're going to get a good tight fit inside your bore. It's going to really put some pressure in there and scrape those contaminants out of the barrel, which is what you're trying to do, and you're not going to harm your barrel. So anyway, it's just a little advice for you. I hope this is helpful. Thanks for watching, and keep up the videos. Fun to watch.